Hey, what's up guys? Today we'll be looking into how to integrate authentication using Auth0 into a Next.js app. It's gonna be extremely simple and we'll do it in a very fast manner. So the first thing we'll need is of course Next.js app. So let's go to docs. Let's go to install one with TypeScript. Go to your terminal, slap that in. My app will be secret codes. And when that's done, it should create a new file with your project name. Let's just cd into it and open it. So what you'll see is just a Next.js project. It has pages, API routes, public with some icons, and also with some styles. Next, we need an Auth0 account. If you don't have it, just go ahead and sign up, but I'll log in. Once you have an account on Auth0, just head down to applications and just create a new application. Click on single page web application, let's call it secret codes or whatever you want. Now go to your settings, scroll down to allowed callback URLs and paste this in, which is API of callback. And for logout, we'll need this as a home URL. When you have a production build, you have to add one for your production build. So just separate it by commas and add your URL for the production build. But for now, we just need this. Let's go ahead and save that. Awesome. So the next thing we'll need to do is to create an env file. In the env file, we'll need those variables here. So those two are the same. And now for the issuer base URL, we just go ahead and copy this domain. Paste this in, make sure to leave HTTPS. Client ID, paste this in, and client secret right here. Next, we'll need to install Auth0. So we can just say npm install and just copy this in and then dash dash save. Once it's done, go back to your code and go to dash app dsx. We have to wrap our app in the user provider component. So let's say user provider, just paste your component in and we're done here. So let's create a couple of pages. Let's create a page called codes, do index.dsx. Let's just copy what we have in home. We don't need that much. Let's leave the container here. So let's just say this is secret codes list, rename that to codes page. And then let's say we have some props coming from the server. So let's say get server side props, return props codes, which will be just ID 1, code 123, a couple more. Now in our component, we just accept the codes and just map them. Codes, by the way, let's type this interface props codes. This would be objects of number code string, and then this will be an array. Let's just say props, and in codes we can just map them. Code p tag, let's say id is code.id, and then code is code.code. Now let's try to run this. VM run dev. Okay, we see our page here. We also can edit the home page to look something different. Let's just say h1 secret codes app. Yes, and let's just link to our page. href codes codes page. Now we have a codes page here, so if we click on that, we'll see our page with codes that we supposedly got from the server. So let's say we want to protect this page, the codes page. How do we do that? Instead of doing this, what we have to do is do export const get server site props with page auth required, and just say async get server site props, and here we just say the same as we did before. There we go. And this is erroring because our import is not correct. So what we have to do is correct this import to be this exactly. So now what we have to do as well is create a new folder in the API folder, call it auth, and then create a new file in auth folder, which is called square brackets auth0.ts. So here we'll just have to export handle auth function of auth0. Now let's just go back to the page, refresh that, go to the codes page, and we see that we are presented with a login screen. So we can just log in, go ahead and allow that, and we are logged in. If we would start another session, you would see that we have to log in again, but here we're logged in, so we only can see this page because we are logged in. Now, if this page wouldn't have any data, you could just do an empty function. And this way, it's also protected from the server side. So this is what you would do if you would want to protect it from server side. So the user will not even hit the render function because the page is protected from the server. Therefore, it will check and just stop the unauthorized user there. Another thing you could do is just handle the user in the function. So in order to do that, we just delete this. And here we just add the hook, which will say user error is loading and then equals use user. Now with this parameters, we can say if there is no user, it means that you are not authenticated, please log in. We can just present this message and the user will know that he is not authenticated, therefore cannot see this page. If we say error, if there is an error, and this should be before user because there could be an issue there, just say there was an error, and if it's loading, we can also just show a loading screen or something like that. In this case, we'll just say loading. So we also would not have any data here from the server side. So if we refresh this page here, we can see that we can see this page, but when we log out, we'll not be able to see that. So let's just add a logout link, href API auth logout. You just say logout. Let's go back, click on this, and now we're logged out. So if we go to the codes page, it says that we're not authenticated. So we can also tell a user that they have to log in and provide the login link. So let's say href auth API auth login, just say login, and now we have the login link here. It says you're not authenticated, please log in. We click on login and then we log in. So the approach you use is really dependent on the use case. If there is a static generation, it's better to use this one. If there is a server-side generation, it could be better to use that one. It really is up to your use case. I personally like this one because I control the whole flow of what's happening, but you could also control the flow by using the extra parameters in the with page of required function. So be sure to check out Next.js and Auth0 pages to know what use case is best for you. But either one of those works really well. So let's say we also had an API route. Let's say there was a codes route, say index.ds, and let's say we copy what we have in the hello function here and delete what we don't need here. And let's just say we handle the codes. Let's just copy those. Say codes. Now we are returning codes from the API. Let's see, API codes. Yep. As we see, we are returning the codes. So in order to protect this route, all we have to do is just wrap it in the with API auth required. So let's do export default with API auth required. Say this. Also, we have to make it a function. And now if I refresh this, we still see that we are seeing the codes. That's because we're logged in. So if we log out and refresh this page, you'll see that it's not going to give us the codes because we're not authenticated. So this API route is also protected now. We can also try fetching it in our codes page. We can go ahead and just do export const get server side props. And say with page auth required. This will also protect the page. Say async get server side props and say const res await fetch http localhost 3000 API codes, and then we need the codes await res json props codes. Now we have to go back to what we had before. So it's interface props codes, get the codes here. Pass the props here. Go here. And just say codes map code. P tag ID code. ID, code, code, code. Now if we go back, here we'll see an error. That's because we're not authenticated. So in order to authenticate with this route, we have to pass in the headers. We have to say headers, cookie. We have to also grab context and say context request headers cookie. Now what we also have to do is just extract it from the JSON. So now we see the codes here. If we remove page auth required, make this into a function with context, and we refresh this, this would still work. But if we would log out here, everything would still work because we're checking the user here. We also have to make sure that codes are fallbacking on an empty array so it would not fail. And we see you're not authenticated, please log in. We click on login. And we're logged in. So that's it for the video, guys. I hope it helped you. If you have any questions, just let me know in the comment section. Subscribe for more. Have a great one.